Yeah, I was in New York. I was doing a lot of theater. And I said, let me go out to L.A. and give it a try. So I went out there, got a job as a doorman at a very swanky club in Beverly Hills. And then one day, I didn't let this guy into the club. And he was very upset with me because he happened to be Swifty Lazar, who was the biggest acting agent in the world at William Morris. And I got fired, just like he said I would. And I went home, sat down at the edge of my bed, and I said, what the hell am I going to do with my life? And I remember my father writing on a card, the saddest thing in life is wasted talent. Don't waste your life, son. And I saw that card on my refrigerator, and I said, well, I promised my dad I was not going to waste my talent and my life. I got to do something. If they won't give me a great part, then I'll write one myself. And I started writing this killing that I saw when I was 9 years old. And I performed it for my theater workshop that Monday, and everybody was kind of stunned, and they just kind of stood there with their mouths open. And I said, wait a minute, this could be something here. I opened the play in Los Angeles, and it was like a rocket took off. The reviews came out, and they were just over the top, and people just flocked to this little theater, and there was lines around the block. And every writer, director, actor, studio head, producer came to see that show, because everybody wanted a piece of it. Every writer wanted to write the story. Every director wanted to direct the movie. Every star wanted to play Sonny. It was insane. And a few weeks after that, I signed with William Morris, and then we got offered $1 million. I was sitting down at this big table, and the guy had his hand on a piece of paper, and he slid it across to where I was sitting. And he said, if you sign that paper, Chazz, you'll have a check tomorrow for $1 million. And I said, well, I want to play Sonny and I want to write the screenplay. And they said, no, Chazz, you know, you're a wonderful actor, but you're nobody. Nobody knows who you are. We can't do that. And I asked him, I said, is there a bathroom around here? And he said, yeah, right over there. I said, I'll talk to you in 1 second. And I walked into this big executive bathroom and I looked in the mirror and I washed my hands, put water on my face and kind of looked at myself, put my hand in my pocket. And I realized that I took my father's card with me. The saddest thing in life is wasted talent. I looked at the card and I just said, fuck it. I'm not doing it.